Hey everybody, welcome back. Lemon Zest Home Cooking Series here 2020. Easter may be gone, but the rock and roll lives on. We're going to be cooking tonight an inspired dish from Louisiana. That's a shout out to Flora and Patrick, the Gomez family, all you guys up there. We know what's going on. Ray Arias, I know you're in Carolina, but this one's for you too. We're going to make some Etouffee, shrimp etouffee. Let's see if I know what I'm doing over here. I'm going to start by making a roux. Roux is traditionally either butter and oil, butter, oil, and flour combination. Today we're using vegetable oil. I'm going to mix in some all-purpose flour into that and make the roux. That's going to be really important to our dish. And we're going to cook this roux and brown it. So again, I've got vegetable oil in there. I'm gonna get some flour in there. We're gonna cook this roux down. That's one of the important things of Louisiana style Cajun Creole cooking from the South, is making a real roux, not that quick one to just drop in your soup and boil it down. This is gonna actually add intense flavor and color to the finished product. So again, I'm using oil today, vegetable oil. You can see how it's mixing together with the flour. And we're gonna cook that roux down. So let me get it incorporated. We're gonna get some color on it. Something that it will heat. But you gotta keep your eye on this. You want a brown roux. This could take a few minutes. So alright, let's let that stuff go a little bit here. Okay, you got your roux cooking. You're gonna wanna have for this dish, the etouffee, the following ingredients. Everybody knows this from Louisiana cooking, the Holy Trinity, right? Pepper, I got sweet bell pepper, onion and celery. There's the Trinity, the Holy Trinity they call it. We have to have scallions. We got a bit of tomato sauce. This is a basic tomato sauce. You can use tomato paste, you can use canned tomatoes, chopped, stewed tomatoes. Whatever you like. I've got my house-made Cajun spice blend. So that means, you know, Paul Prudhomme, look out. I make my own now. We also, tonight I'm gonna use roasted garlic, but you could use fresh sliced garlic. You can see that this is some of the roasted garlic from the other night. Some of that oil in there. We're gonna end up cooking that baby zucchini with the roasted garlic oil, and always have some fresh thyme available. Oh yeah, that smells good. All right, and then we're gonna do tonight the shrimp etouffee. Could be crawfish, but tonight it's shrimp. You don't have to use giant shrimp, but use whatever you can afford. Those are cheap, so that's why I got them going. Etouffee, again, means kind of like smothered. So we're gonna make this smothered rice dish. I've already cooked some rice. I have that warm sitting on the fire. And here is gonna be the base for the etouffee. That's a nice shrimp stock. All right, made that the other day. Some of you may have seen it. And we're gonna use that to thicken up the sauce. That's gonna be the base for the sauce, is the shrimp, usually a seafood stock. I'm gonna get a little bit of messy flour out of here. I can smell that roux now. The flour's starting to cook, get toasted. So it's gonna get cooked up, right up. I got it on hot, I got hot stock. Again, we'll take a look at the ingredients. Shrimp etouffee tonight here at Lemon Zest. Small shrimp, they could be big. Holy Trinity, scallion, tomato, fresh thyme, roasted garlic, and the oil to saute the zucchini. I'd love to have some okra, but not tonight. And then a Cajun spice blend. So let me toast up. You can see here, this is starting to get toasted. See the inside of the pan down here? This brown color here, this is what we want. You can smell the aroma. Can you smell it, Nelly?
Yes.
Don't forget about Nelly, y'all. Send your wishes to Nelly. She's over here working hard, doing all the dishes after me cooking. Yeah, she's cleaning. Hey, we better turn this on before we burn the place down. This is going to be a little more than what they call a blonde roux. We're going to get this with some coloring. You can see some of this. Some of the pieces down in there are starting to pick up that color from the pan. We're gonna keep stirring. Be patient, it's gonna take a little while, this one tonight. Again, I have hot shrimp stock is gonna be the base. You can see that white flour starting to turn tan now, right? Starting to get some color on the roux. Do you notice the difference? Because I do. I can see it. And I can smell toasted flour here. And that's really what we're looking for here. Some roux can take 45 minutes or more to get to the right consistency when they're doing the etouffee. So anytime you make something out of the South and it calls for roux, they're gonna want you to cook that first and then add your ingredients into it rather than vice versa. So let me see what we got going here. You see the color difference now from a white flour? This is what it used to look like, white. Now you can see it's tan. All right, it's toasted. Good. All right, let me get some of the ingredients. We're gonna go in with the vegetables. The Trinity, right? Some of that blend, celery, sweet pepper, onion. Put it all in there. It's gonna be a big batch. Etouffee. We're done with this now. Now I'm gonna use a high heat spatula here. Cook that down with the roux. You can hear it sizzling and popping. Take a listen to that, watch that go. I'm gonna come on in with the scallions now. Green scallions. Cebollinas. Okay, keep your eye on the pan. Keep stirring it, okay? Uh-oh. Now we're gonna turn this stock. It's coming in here now. Incorporate that stock in there, that shrimp stock with that roux and the Trinity. Get that stuff going down here. Remember, the etouffee is gonna be served over rice. Hot pan, hot stock, here we go. Plenty of roux. You wanna get that cooking right away? It's not a quick dish, so let's take our time. We'll listen to some music. Yeah, there you go. I'm gonna get a little more of that shrimp stock. Keep your eye on that while I'm getting the stock going. I'm going to go ahead and add into the etouffee base that roasted garlic, okay? And then, like I mentioned, I'm going to put the oil back here in the back. That'll be for the sauteed baby zucchinis that are going to go with it. Okay, here's some more shrimp stock coming in. If you don't have shrimp stock, you can use chicken stock, vegetable stock. Like I mentioned, crawfish, crayfish, crawdaddies, you name it, they're gonna work in this too. That burner's off that the shrimp stock was on. You can see how that roux that we put together is starting to thicken that up real nice. Keep your eye on that while it's bubbling. Speaking of bubbling, we're going to add our tomato product in there now and get that bubbling. Nice color, nice color. There's a little bit more of that shrimp stock in here. You can see what that toasted roux has done. It's added color to this. A nice thick consistency. Put that right on the fire there. Let me clean up my mess here quickly. Move this whisk out of your way so you can see everything starting to simmer and bubble down. Bubble trouble. Just keep stirring your pan around. Make sure nothing's sticking. The roux. Looks like we got a nice consistency going there. So we're going to let that cook down. Simmer. On high temperature, I'm gonna keep it boiling and then turn it down. There you go. Look at that velvety consistency. Let's go ahead and come on in. We're gonna get some of that Cajun spice in there next. There you can see the different paprika-based garlic, onion, cayenne pepper, black pepper, white pepper. I put a little dry mustard in mine. I like to flavor that dry mustard in there. There's your blackening spice or your Cajun blend or your house made, homemade. Oh yeah. I'm gonna blend that all together, this etouffee. Have a nice blend. If you had some bay leaves, which I don't have here at the house, a couple bay leaves would be nice. Now look at the color change. Now the Cajun blend is in. See it starting to bubble. Watch that thing bubble. Bubble. I'm going to put a couple sprigs of fresh thyme in here too. Fresh thyme was another ingredient in that Cajun spice blend. Alright, so some stems. Them stems in there. So as that's cooking, we're going to let that simmer down. Keep your eye on that as it's going. Keep stirring it. You can see we got a nice consistency here. The roux is holding it pretty tight. All right, a little more Cajun. So we get our zucchini in there. You can see that's bubbling away. That roux is thickening up. That shrimp stock is in there. If we had some okra, wouldn't that be nice? Wouldn't that be a treat? All those veggies in there, the holy trinity is bubbling away, bubbling away. Let's wait till this heats up a little bit up and back. Again, I used some of the roasted garlic oil. If you've seen some of the other shows, made it right here in the microwave, nice and easy, right in the microwave. Let's turn this etouffee sauce down a little bit. See the deep color that's got now? That's a combination of the roux, the tomato sauce, and some of the Cajun spices, but that's bubbling really nice. We're gonna wait till that oil heats up. Remember how we like cooking with hot pans? So that's gonna be the next thing we do is saute our baby zucchini. That's gonna go along with the etouffee. Another tasting spoon out. Let's see what we got going here. Oh yeah, I'll do it. Need to get me a Budweiser. One of them PBRs. Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah, man. It's like grandma. No granny. Yeah, I can see this is gonna be nice and hot. Get these zucchinis going back here in the back. They're gonna be garnish more than anything else to accompany your shrimp etouffee. The last thing we're gonna add in, gonna season these with a little salt and pepper. Remember, we like to do that all the time. Etouffee paste falling away. Whoops. It's just for Nelly. Get in here and see how we're doing. That's your baby zucchini. Again, sauteed and roasted garlic oil. Season with a little salt and pepper. Use it for a little garnish texture. It's a nice dish, which is a shrimp etouffee. Cast iron skillet works real good for this too. Handle that high heat. These really fast. Speaking of really fast, I'm going to take some of this etouffee sauce out of here. Let it keep cooking. It's going to be some extra etouffee sauce. Try to leave most of the spices in there, veggies. There, take a look there. You can see all the Holy Trinity in there now. The celery, the pepper, the pepper, the onion. Reminds me of Patrick. Pepper. All right. Let me get the zucchini flipped over back here. Here. Let me move that for you, Nelly. There we go. Baby zucchini, crispy. Yeah, there you go. It looks a little color. Want to still be all crunchy. I know some of you like your greens cooked to a nothing, but you got the final ingredient in the etouffee, the shrimp tonight. These are small shrimp, so that's why I'm adding them right at the end. I am not going to overcook these bad boys. So they're going to go the last thing in. It's going to be the etouffee. Remember, we already have the flavor of shrimp in there from the shrimp stock. Stirred in the etouffee sauce. Yeah. One more flip of these. Zucchini, that's what we're looking for, a little color. Shut that off. Get the spoon going here. Let's see how our rice is doing. Rice is hot. Fresh cooked rice. There you go. Etouffee. Yeah, let's get ready to plate our dinner here tonight. Over this way, follow the zucchini. I'm going around the plate with the zucchini. You can present them this way if you want, but I want to see the colors there. There's your zucchini. Next thing you know, rice goes in the middle, right? This is a smothered dish. So we're going to put rice down. Again, we're going to leave a little room for that etouffee to float right in the middle of that rice. Gotta love Zydeco music. Here at etouffee, you can see the shrimp are cooked. It's taking only 2 minutes because of the small ones. If you had some jumbo lump crab, you can put it in here now. That would be a great addition to this dish. There's that. And then we're gonna bring the etouffee to the plate. Here we go. It's hot, look out. Take a look at this. See those shrimps in that etouffee sauce? Don't mind the thyme sprigs. They'll be fine. Next plate, shrimp etouffee, Louisiana style. Trying to give you a little something from all over. Again, shout out to all the family, Louisiana, where you at? I know where you at. Where you at? You got it. Who dat? Who dat nation? There you have it tonight. Here at Lemon Sis. Home cooking. The shrimp. Etouffee. Hey. Olay. Who dat?